Even the IT department. I know y'all had issues. It takes us too long. It's kind of like a government, you know, hey, those days are over. You know, we got to be lean, mean, and efficient. And again, it's all tax dollars, and that's what the public's paying for, and they deserve it. So there's no stepping your boundaries.
We have, you know, got some names for vendors who can put the equipment in the RMC and have that electronic recording up and running. Like I said, minimal cost to the county with the people that we have in place. I mean, you know, of course, we have to drag some of us into the technological world, kicking and screaming, but I think that's the right route to take. And I think what we're doing now in delinquent tax, and y'all have to stop me because I'm very excited about some of the things that we're doing, and we're cutting costs right and left in what we've got planned, and we plan to make it, like you said, very lean and very efficient, and we've even started doing some of this work. And we like the way it looks, and we're going to keep perfecting it as we go. So I don't know how much time that Hope and Ponda have had to look into such things, but we're very excited about what we've talked about. We, you know, brought some other departments in and got input from them, so on.
I'd like to hear what you think.
An extremely large amount of time researching this, especially with records management. And I know when I came on board, Ponda, Judge Caldwell has helped out a lot. My concern is, and like you said, just kind of folks being a little more territorial, overstepping bounds. But my question was, this is for the citizens of Spartanburg County. What is the problem? Why can't we work together? You know, we need progression and not just sitting back saying, well, and basically what I found is, you know, certain people were used to being in charge and used to making the decisions and didn't want to hear from me and basically was just unresponsive until all this started happening. I'm thinking, we've got to do better. This is unacceptable. I mean, me spending time on the phones with abstractors and paralegals and attorneys about why they can't get a scanned document, which I still don't understand why court's documents have were stopped being scanned in 2001. It's just unbeknownst to me, and nobody can explain that to me. Why would we continue this paper route when we can use technology to help advance this? Well, they won't even have to come into the offices. I mean, they could be offered electronically. I mean, I just don't understand it, and I've run into roadblocks until all this started coming. Now, I mean, things are rocking and rolling. The only issue that's holding us back from really going forward and scanning and putting this out here electronically is the software to index and redact. So we're scanning, but it's just kind of sitting there waiting for IT to come back with something to give us. We're going to go down to Richland and look at the own base software just to see what they have set up. We actually, some staff went over to Security Finance, I think it was, who used that. And I'm thinking that's where IT's going. You know, with my limited ability to know exactly what the right equipment is, I depend on their expertise to advise us. And, you know, I don't want to rush in anything, but does it need to take a whole year to research this?
No, it doesn't. I mean, I don't think it does.
I just don't understand it. And there have been some debates going back and forth with me, but, you know, it's been said that I want what I want when I want it. That's not the case, but, I mean, I'm here to do a job, and I just have a lack of tolerance for people who are used to doing it that way and they don't want to change when it's going to advance Spartanburg County. And I'm ready to rock and roll and help everybody who comes in that office to get what they need and get out. And if they don't even have to come in, you know, I bought a whole stack of pen drives for cases that can be scanned. We'll let the abstractors or attorneys purchase that with the cost of what we paid for the actual drive and the percentage of time it costs to scan it, and they can get on out of there. I mean, it doesn't take, we shouldn't have someone standing at a copying pages, 1,000, 2,000 pages. I mean, we only have two copiers. That would take a whole day to do that. The thought process, I think, in my opinion, needs to change. Having come from state government and doing things a certain way, I try to follow policy exactly the way it should be, and I've studied Spartanburg County policy, and, you know, when I made some changes, like, why are you doing this policy? Do you not know this? Where, I mean, where have y'all been? You've been here for all these years and you don't know this? So it, I just think it, people need to understand that, you know, my employees understand that if they're not gonna work, then they need to move on, because sitting there coming and doing a job and doing the bare minimum is unacceptable for me. And that's not for any other reason other than to serve folks that we need to serve.
And we can have the system almost to where you can check 30 years back on a title without even coming into this building. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the way we're all three looking to move. And I think that's what the paralegals were concerned about, is that we're kind of years behind and we're wanting to come into the future to where you can check a title without physically coming into the office in most cases.
Well, that's what I've heard. I mean, again, since those paralegals met with us last year in conversations with y'all, and then talking to folks over in Greenville, I've talked to those, Dale's talked to Cherokee County. I mean, when you don't have the attorneys and paralegals come into the office, you don't need as many people. I mean, if you're not having to do all this stuff by hand and keep all these other documents, you don't need as many folks in that office, and it saves time, efficiency for both lawyers and paralegals and our team. And the brain drain is incredible when you're doing it like in the 70s or 80s.
I do think we need to be mindful, though, that what we do affects so many other departments. And I think one of IT's problems and why they may have approached this a little more slowly is we've got this department with this software and this department with this one and this one with this one, and they don't interact, they don't communicate.
Good point.
And yeah, we need something countywide, so not only can the public communicate, but we need to be able to communicate with each other better than we can.
Well, that's one of the conversations.
Part of that brings up something that we've discussed so many times in council and with our administrative staff, is dual training. And that's, you know, if we're going to spend some money, and we're going to have to do that, as I said before, to update our system, I think it behooves us to get something that the three departments can work together in similarity. And that way, if you know, if you need some extra help, you know, somebody from Ponda's office, you know, may have a little bit of free time that day, and they won't come over here and be thrown into an alien world. You know, they should be able to, you know, take the software and work with it. So,
you know, the state has a system, and on the circuit court side in the clerk's office, they're scanning because the software is there to index it and get it, and we're sending stuff out electronically. It just started, but I mean, I've got to find some more money to get other scanners, but these clerks have these scanners on their desk, and they're inputting that into the system, and we're actually starting to send files out now electronically on that side. But family court doesn't have that yet. It's, hopefully it's coming, but all the old stuff, yeah, that
instead of manually entering the data, I mean, they can run it through a scanner and it's there.
They're starting from the here now, but I've got to be able to go back. I just said there's no point trying to start from day one, and that goes years and years back. We'll start now, and then hopefully when money comes and support comes, we'll meet somewhere in the middle. But as these things are being done, we're already sending them out, and I've heard a lot of positive response on it. So there are things out there, and it will work, and it'll be beneficial for all. And like I said, less employees. You know, when I was researching RMC office and with records management, there's a scanner out there that will scan microfilm, that will bring that up to date, and we can do away with all microfilm because that all, it gets torn. Some of it's been lost. I mean, it's going to take a little bit of money to buy one, but think of all the time it's going to save from going through and pulling that film out, putting it in the machine. It's going to, it'll pick it up and scan it. And that machine, it's about $12,000, but I mean, RMC will need it, and so will the clerk's office.
Well, we're spending money at the landfill. You know, when we buy equipment, it's hundreds of thousands of dollars. I mean, and this is equally, if not more important. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is forever. I mean, I remember having discussions with you, Hope, stuff that you have to have in your department that's required by law, we have to keep forever. I mean, especially when you start talking about, you know, case information, you know, when people are going to trial or whatever, all that stuff. And one of the things I remember, Sharon, when we met with you, you talked about, again, kind of like Ponda said, that our software being able to go throughout the county.
Exactly.
This time of, this is my software, it's what I'm used to, mm-hmm. you know, it's got to be countywide. I mean, again, it's the taxpayers that are paying for it, and it's ridiculous for us to have departments just saying, you know, this is what I'm used to, this is what we want to do, no more. You know, and y'all need to help us with that. Again, we don't see this stuff. We don't hear it. We didn't know it until y'all were telling us. So.
You know, and one of the problems that with records management, when I came in and I discussed this with you, and I got a lot of emails from ex-records, is being able to get the file the same day, and that whole situation still baffles me, because I'm thinking, why can't we? I was just told we couldn't. They didn't come the same day. Well, I had a meeting, set it up with Trim, and they were there all of a minute. I said, well, I don't understand why we're here. We delivered the file the same day. It was just a management issue of someone not wanting to deliver it the same day. And that was fixed within the first 3 minutes of that meeting. I said, I'm sorry I waste y'all's time. This was unacceptable. And we got that changed, but it's ridiculous. It's that territorial thing of, I made this decision and this is what I say it goes, but you're still not doing what's best for the citizens of Farmer County. And they just want to complain. And I'm thinking, that's not the case.
I had some of these things that we can look at, and probably, because I had an attorney from Greer call me this morning when he read in the paper that we were going to be having this meeting today. And since he is in Greer, he does lots of business with the ROD office in Greenville. Mm-hmm. And he was talking about what they have in place and how it costs the county virtually nothing to put it in, because it's a web-based file system, and the attorneys pay a fee per year and a fee per document to have it scanned, electronically filed, and it costs the county nothing. It even calculates the fees, the stamps, and everything. And that way, you make sure you get your money. And he said, you know, the money is debited from my account. The provider pays the money up front when it's recorded and then debits his account. And he said, it's worth his weight in gold to do it that way without having to waste time getting documents over to the courthouse.
That could be one smooth process. And it's not. If I'm not mistaken, and you correct me, Ponda, it's not that expensive to start up.
He said there'd be very little cost to the county to start that up.
Very little work that would have to be done to actually start that up. With that. I guess the biggest thing would be the training everybody to do it and learn it. That's, you know, when you get my age, which is close to 40. It's kind of hard. It's slow. Your learning slows down, actually. Mm-hmm. Y'all might not know that, but it does. But I think that's the hardest thing. And when Hope speaks to people not wanting to change, just because a lot, maybe they're afraid to change and they don't want to try something new. But I remember back in 1981, when we first put our computer system in, it was weeks. I'm saying, bring back my paper. I don't like this stuff. And now, if the computer goes down for 2 seconds, we're lost. I mean, everybody's eyes just glaze over. What are we going to do? You know, so it takes a little while to indoctrinate us to a change. But once we get past that learning and we know that it's not something that's going to turn around and bite us, then, you know, we'll accept it and embrace it. And I think that's what we're all saying, is that this can be done. And it doesn't have to be financially crippling to the county to do it. I think it's a very, very cost to start this up and to address a lot of this.
What are our first steps? I mean, and I know we need to get IT involved.
Certainly.
Do you feel like that maybe we need to get our IT to, you know, and I don't know. I mean, I've always felt like in so many things that we undertake, we don't have to reinvent the wheel.
Right.
You know, it's out there. We just need to look at it and decide what size wheel we need, I guess. So do you guys agree that maybe we need to get maybe a group together with our IT, maybe look at Greenville, maybe look at Cherokee or and some other, I mean, you know, to, and